Welcome to the Angular Color Picker tutorial. Using the Syncfusion Angular Color Picker component, you can find and pick the perfect color with its various color specifications like RGB, HSV, or hex codes. Pick the colors by selecting from the color values or adjusting the hue and opacity values. In this video, I will show you how to create an Angular app and add the Syncfusion Angular Color Picker component. You will see how to set values at the initial load, display the color picker using different modes, hide the input area, and customize the palette with user-defined colors. Let me start with the application creation process. I'm going to create an Angular application using the Angular CLI tool. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Node.js. First, open Visual Studio Code and install the Angular CLI using the npm install -g at angular/cli command. As I have already installed it, I am skipping this step here. Next, I will create a new Angular project. I use the ng new project name command and name my project example. I am creating a project with the option to add a CSS style sheet, so I choose the CSS option. The project creation has started, and it is creating an Angular project with its dependencies. Now, let me navigate to the project folder. To add the Syncfusion Angular Color Picker component, install the Syncfusion Angular Inputs package using the npm install at syncfusion/ej2angularinputs --save command. This will install the package with its dependencies. The application is now ready to use. Before using the Syncfusion component, I need to register the trial license key. I open the main.ts file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To generate this license key, refer to the link in the description below. The application is now configured to use Syncfusion components. First, I navigate to the app component.ts file and import the color picker module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Inputs package. Then register it within the imports array of the component section. Next, navigate to the app component HTML file and remove its default content and add a division element with the ID wrapper. And place the header tag, choose a color. Then add the input element with the EJ's color picker attribute and specify its ID and type properties. Next, to reference the CSS styles for the color picker, navigate to the style.css file and import the material theme. I have also added the dependent CSS references like buttons, split buttons, and pop-ups. Then, I add the text-align style for the ID wrapper. I save the changes and run the application using the ng serve command. See the color picker component displayed. When I click the split button, you can see the pop-up showing different colors. From here, you can switch to the palette mode by just clicking the mode switcher and then picking the colors you need. The default color on the color picker is green. If you want to change the color on the initial load, use the value property. I define the value property, which accepts 3- to 6-digit hex color codes. I set a 4-digit hex code to it. In this color code, the last digit represents opacity. Now, the color specified in the value property is set to be selected by default. The picker mode is shown on the initial load. The Syncfusion Angular Color Picker also supports palette and inline modes. To demonstrate the palette mode, I set the mode property to palette. you can see the color picker displayed in palette mode. To render the palette without the split button, set the inline property to true. Now, the palette renders without the split button. To disable switching modes dynamically, I need to hide the mode switcher here. To do that, I set the mode switcher property to false. Now, the color picker renders without the mode switcher. Similarly, you can also hide the apply and cancel buttons. To hide the control buttons, set the show buttons property to false. Now the color picker component renders without any buttons. By default, the palette contains a color in each tile. If you want to display the color picker with the no color option, use the no color property. This property will display the first tile without any color. To demonstrate, I set the no color property to true. Looking here, the first tile has no color. The palette is rendered with a default set of colors. I can also load custom colors into the palette using the preset colors property. First, navigate to the app component TS file and declare the custom colors object. Then, add custom colors to the custom field. I assign this object to the preset colors property of the input element. As I want to add 4 columns to the palette, I set the columns property to 4. To apply custom styles to the palette, I add the before tile render event with the tile render event handler. Inside the app component TS file, I import the palette tile event args from the J2 Angular inputs package, and then import the add class function from EJ2 base package. Next, define the event handler tile render, which receives the argument of type palette tile event args. Within this event handler, add the classes eIcon and eCustomTile using the add class function. Finally, I add few styles and content to those classes. Looking here, the palette displays the specified custom colors. Next, I will show you how to apply a color to the target element by choosing it from the color picker. To do that, I add a division element and set its ID to preview. Then, in the style.css file, I add the style for this ID preview. I have specified the default background color. To apply colors chosen from the palette, I add the change event with the onChange event handler. This event will be triggered whenever a color is chosen from the color picker. In the app component TS file, import the color picker event args from the EJ2 Angular inputs package. Then define the method onChange, which receives the argument of type color picker event args. Inside this event handler, I get the element with ID preview and set the hex value obtained from the args current value to the background color property. When I select a color from the color picker, it is applied to the division element. Now I will show you how to hide the input area in picker mode. For better clarity, I remove all the customizations done so far. To hide the input area, I add the CSS class property and set it to eHideValue. And the picker mode is rendered without the input area. Finally, to disable the color picker component, I set the disabled property to true. See now, the color picker component is disabled. In this video, I've shown you how to add the color picker component to an Angular application. I also showed you a few of its basic features like setting a value, disabling the switcher mode, displaying no color option, and adding custom colors. If you want to see a working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link to see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Angular products through our community license. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.